Hi, I'm Chef Costa Magoulas, and on this episode of Local Flavor, we're cooking with the roughest, toughest reptile here in Florida. Welcome to Local Flavor. Once again, I'm Chef Costa Magoulas. On this episode, we're cooking with a local ingredient, alligator. Joining me tonight is Josh Mattson. Josh runs an airboat and gator service here in Florida. Welcome to the show, Josh.
Thanks for having me, Chef.
I really appreciate you coming down. We're going to talk about gators and everything.
Yeah.
But tell me a little bit, how did you get started in this?
Grew up in DeLand. Came over here to DSC after high school and went ahead.
Good move.
Yeah, thanks. And after finishing up here, went in doing some different things and always ended up back on the river working on the water. So I ended up getting my captain's license and everything's kind of fallen in place since then.
That's fantastic. I want to remind everyone that this is a call-in show. Remember that. 1-800-901-9238. That's 1-800-901-9238. You can call us about alligators, about hunting, about the recipes we're going to do tonight. So give us a call. We're looking forward to that. Now, we're going to be talking about alligators here and about what your day is like in the life of an alligator hunter, you know, or charter. Mm-hmm. And we're going to have some footage here in just a minute.
Yeah.
And there it is.
Yeah. So the majority of our day, we just do airboat tours. So we're actually taking people out. We're not actually hunting alligators.
Man, that looks like fun.
Yeah, it's a great time. It's like flying on the water. So beautiful sections of river here in Volusia County. So go ahead and cover a lot of ground during our tours. Don't try to stop and talk too much.
Yeah.
And then during gator season, which runs August 15th to November 1st.
I was wondering when the season was.
Yeah, it's the same time every year. So Halloween night is the last night every year. Most of the hunting's at night from 5 p.m. to 10 a.m.
You see many of these?
Yeah, lots of gators in the night.
Yep. Oh, boy.
So this is obviously not during gator season. They don't just lay there for you during the public season. But go out at night, use a light to shine their eyes, and it lets you know where they're at.
Oh, is that how they do that?
Yep. And you can work in and see if it's an alligator you're interested in harvesting or not.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm just fascinated by alligators. I think a lot of people are right now.
Oh, yeah.
We really got them here in Florida, too.
Yep, we have between 1.25 million and 2 million. It's kind of hard to tell exactly how many adult gators.
Now, you were talking about alligator season. They have to have permits for that?
Yeah, it's all permitted through the state. We have two different types of ways to hunt them here. We have a public and a private. The public is the August 15th to November 1st. Private, it's actually big pieces of land, like Big Sugar and things like that. And that runs year-round. They actually manage their own gators with their own biologist.
Now, can anybody get a permit to do gators?
Yep, anyone 18 or older can get a permit, residents, non-residents, and basically it's all by draw. So in the spring, they have a drawing for a set number of tags for each area, and everyone applies. And if you're successful, you get two tags.
Oh, really? That's how that works. That's pretty interesting. Well, that's just beautiful out there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a gorgeous section of river.
Is there a different species of alligator here in Florida?
No, there's one type of species, American alligator, but we do have two different types of crocodilians. We have a saltwater crocodile in South Florida, which is, you know, it's actually south of Okeechobee.
Yeah,
mainly
I've heard
in the very
that.
Southern it, Everglades yeah. And into the Keys, we have some crocodiles.
Yeah, I'm going to catch one like that. Yeah. I don't think so.
Yeah, you don't want to catch one any bigger than that, barehanded.
Boy, that's something. Can they see underwater real well?
Not fairly well. They have a goggle that comes from the front. It's actually a second eyelid that comes from the front, and they're able to pull that over their eye, and then as they're swimming underwater, they keep that as it acts as a goggle.
That's
when they pull
amazing.
Up, they retract it.
Well, we want to remind everybody, it's 1-800-901-9238 with your questions, and I'm going to get started here doing a little cooking,
yeah,
so
sounds good.
We're going to keep talking a little bit. I'm heating up my oil over here, and you know I'm using my canola and olive oil blend. That's my special oil that I like a lot of. This oil is not quite hot yet. This is the alligator here. What do you think about that, Josh?
That looks good, nice and clean.
Now that's the alligator tail, right?
Correct.
And it's that nice white meat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're getting the redder meat up near the ribs and on the legs.
That's from the ribs. And that's mm-hmm. a little bit tougher and everything?
Yeah, a little more gamey flavor. The tail should be nice and white.
I want to show everybody my special bag. You like my big bag? I got a 2 gallon Ziploc bag. I was talking to everybody about using these bags for breading, the small bags,
mm-hmm.
but I brought a big one in there so you can get a brisket and put in there if you have to. So I'm gonna start putting some gator in here. And I take my gator and I marinate it in buttermilk. I like buttermilk. Mm-hmm. I really think it does a lot for different foods. Fried chicken, gator, scallops, you name it. And for breading, a lot of people here in Florida use cornmeal, cracker meal for their different foods. Myself, I like to use that, but I also like to use items that you can buy, and if you find a real good commercial breading, I think it really works quite well for you. The thing about commercial breadings you have to be careful about is the fact that they're already seasoned, so you don't want to salt and pepper them or anything like that. So this thing looking pretty good in here. See, that's pretty much what it looks like when it's breaded, and I like doing it like this. And we're going to do two recipes tonight. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. So we're doing a fried. We got Brent in Winter Park is calling us tonight. Brent, you about ready to ask a question? What's your question for our caller?
I thoroughly enjoy your show.
Thank you.
My question is, I was through Louisiana not long ago, and I saw at a restaurant an advertisement for alligator sauce pecan. And do you know how to fix that?
Alligator piquois?
Pecan. It's a hot dish.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I started to make that tonight, but I said, I'm going to do something a little different. Actually, I'm going to do a Cajun gator tonight, which is similar to that. But the piquois, you use tomato sauce and tomatoes and cook it. You get a lot of heat. What I'm going to do is make it Cajun style with a half and half cream. You'll see it coming up here in a little bit. Right now, I'm frying this gator. Drop it into my special fryer over. Boy, this meat looks really good.
It looks great.
You know, we were talking about what gator tastes like, and I thought you came up with the best definition.
Yeah, pork.
It tastes white. Like pork.
It's white, but it has a texture and tendency to taste like pork once it's completed.
We got another caller on the line, Josh. Hang on a second, and we're going to take care of that. We got another caller on the line. Who, John? You there, John?
Yep.
Speak up, John. Hey.
Okay, what about that huge alligator rib cage? Have you ever smoked the ribs or barbecued the ribs? And since it tastes like pork, have you ever eaten any alligator ribs?
Generally, the ribs aren't used for two reasons. One is that most people that clean the alligator, when they clean it, they go ahead and take the hide off, and they cut the meat off the tails and as far down the legs as they feel like going. But the inside of an alligator is not very pleasant. They feed mostly on dead things. They really aren't. Yeah, their digestive system isn't something you want to mess with. So typically, a gator isn't gutted or anything like that like most of our mammals are. So actually, most of that's just discarded. Some of the smaller farms where they're harvesting smaller gators, you'll see some of the ribs, but generally people don't eat the ribs on the gator just for that reason.
Hope that answers your question. I know I was watching a fellow skinning a gator and take the meat out, and that dark meat, that doesn't look that good at all.
It's kind of unpleasant.
Now, we're cooking away over here.
I'm saying you pounded it flat, and that's important.
Yeah, that's a good point. I'm glad you brought that up. Gator tail is the most tender, okay? And so that's where we get our best meat. That's the most expensive part of it. And what you have to do, unfortunately, is you got to beat it out a little bit. Now, this meat here is, look how beautiful that white meat of that thing. But I had to take a little mallet and kind of tap it a little bit just to get it more tender. So if you didn't, it'd be awfully chewy, right?
Yeah, it'd be hard to get it down.
Yeah. I'm going to go ahead and keep cooking here. And then we have another caller on the line. And I believe this caller is from DeLand. DeLand, what is it? Jessica.
Oh, yes. Yes, hi.
How you doing, Jessica? What's your question?
My question is for Captain Josh. I was just curious, with all his history of gator hunting and preparing gator, what is the best wine that's paired with gator meat?
I actually wouldn't pair wine with gator meat. Typically, I drink it with a beer. So nice cold beer.
Thank you. Yeah, I can't imagine wine with it. Just, I don't know. I'm making it spicy tonight, and I'd be honest with you, if you had wine with it, it'd be kind of tough.
Yeah.
Maybe a little tequila or something like that. I hope that answers your question.
Thank you. Thanks, Jessica.
All right, bye-bye.
We're still cooking away. While we're cooking this gator, I'm going to make fried green tomatoes tonight, okay? I thought that would go well with this gator. So with the gator, I'm also going to make a blue cheese dressing to go with it. So I have it here. I said, well, while that's frying, I'll knock this out. What I did is I put sour cream, mayonnaise, real good blue cheese, and then I mixed it up real good. Now, some people take and they add a little bit of whipped cream to it. They like it sweet. I'm not real big about it being sweet at all. But I'm going to mix this up. And then I'm also going to take my special salt here that I like. I'm going to show you that. Like that?
Yeah,
well, you can
nice.
Smell it from here. It's got garlic and salt and pepper, and I'm going to put a dab of that in there. I can't hurt it any.
No.
Now, some people like to put a little heat to it. You don't need a lot, but I use the sriracha sauce, and I'm going to put just a... That's all I'm going to put in. I'm not going to overdo it. And some people use hot sauce, Tabasco sauce, or whatever. And this thing is cooking away. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. Josh, you got to help me out here for a second.
Yeah, which needs it.
And tell me if you think this is okay, if it needs anything.
That's perfect.
That's pretty good?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we're going to be ready to roll here in a few minutes, okay? Now, we're almost good. We got to get this a little browner here. We're going to look at this recipe for fried gator. Now, it's real simple, folks. You got to get gator meat and get gator tail, obviously. And you have to cut it up into little cubes and kind of beat it out a little bit. And you take fish breading for the coating. And then you just get your oil into good and hot for about 350 degrees, salt and pepper, and that's it. Now, I marinate it in buttermilk because I think it really works better that way. And this thing is really cooking away in here. Okay, we're going to keep on working here. We can look at our other recipe for a second. We're doing Cajun-style recipe. That's going to be interesting when we get that one. We're looking, the recipe is Cajun-style or our green tomatoes. Okay, we got our other recipe coming. There it is, Cajun gator. All right, this is a little bit more involved, but it's not complicated at all. What I've done here is I have vegetables all chopped up. I have parsley, I've got red onions, yellow onions, garlic, and I mix it all up together. I put a little jalapenos in here, little jalapenos, and I'm going to saute those off in butter, and then I'm going to add the gator to that as well. So we're going to keep on going here. I think we're almost there with this, and I'm going to put a little plate together because I want to fry these as well, these fried tomatoes. Holy cow. Inhaled the wrong way. Live TV, folks. You can't hide that. Now, what I'm going to do is I've taken a green tomato, and you can see it kind of like here, and I've sliced it up, and I marinated it in buttermilk. And then I'm going to fry that as well. As soon as I put some new gloves on. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. Yes? Kate from DeLand? Caitlin. Caitlin from DeLand, what's your question for us?
How long does it take to marinate the alligator?
Well, with me, you can do it hour or two before, overnight. It's up to you, really. You don't have to marinate it too long. Just to get that marinate, that buttermilk really kind of helps tenderize it. And I think it adds flavor to it. I really do. So does that help you there? Now, what we're going to do here, I'm still waiting on this gator. We have another call coming in from St. Cloud. Greg?
Hey. Yeah, hey, how you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. What's your question tonight?
My question is, I've harvested a few gators through the years, legally, you know, the permit deal, and I want to know if the jaw meat is good.
Yeah, actually, the jaw meat's the best part. It's the part of the gator that's
usually...
You know,
I heard that. Right here?
Yep, right here. Yeah, what would be the fattest part on the alligators, just behind the head. It's the most tender. It's the largest muscle, single muscle group on them. And it's what they use the least. It just opens and closes their mouth. That's it. So that's actually the best piece. And as you go through a batch, sometimes you'll get lucky and get a jaw piece in there, and you'll know because you'll be able just to bite right through it without any problem. So, good question.
Well, doesn't that look good?
It's delicious,
I'm sorry, folks, but I'm tied up with this gator here. Don't mess with me too much. No, I'm just teasing. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. I want to get this on a plate. Hey, Barbara from Orlando, you like gator?
Yes, I do.
Good girl. What's your question for us tonight?
Well, we're in the Orlando area, and we were wondering if you knew where we could find fresh alligator without having to go trying to get it ourselves.
You mean you don't want to go hunting? Any suggestions?
There's a couple different places you can get it. Your best place to get it is from any of the local purveyors during the fall. You're getting to be a little bit late, but there's still some chances you can get. You actually can contact me at gatorhunter.com, and I can help you get in touch.
Is that right?
Yep, get you in touch with the right people who have the freshest gator. But in the fall season, a lot of the processors hold on to extra gator, and so it's going to get you the best price. You could try getting it through some of the bigger distributors, but generally the price isn't going to be as good. And if you get it in the fall, most likely it's been taken just in the last couple weeks, so you get nice fresh gator.
Is that right?
Yep.
So that's the best time actually to go for it then?
Yeah, it's the best time to get it locally. You can also get it from the farms from time to time in the spring as well.
Now there's farms in the area?
There are some gator farms. The majority of them are south of here.
Oh, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I can't remember any gator farms around here. I never knew they had them.
Yeah, well, Gatorland and St. Augustine Gator Farm were kill facilities, but I believe that now that Gatorland is not a kill facility, I'm not sure about St. Augustine
Gator that's Farm. Interesting. Well, then I hope that answered your question and answered mine, because I was kind of wondering about that myself. I need to get the rest of this gator out of here. Give me a little second here. We got another little question tonight from Lake Weir. Jake from Lake Weir, are you there?
Yes.
Hi. What's your question for us tonight?
My question is, I know that gator tail can be a little tough.
Yep.
How would you recommend freezing it?
Say that again.
I know that gator tail
is tough.
A little tough.
Yes, ma'am.
How would you recommend freezing it?
It freezes very well. I don't have any problem freezing it, do you?
No. Generally, you can put it in a water bath to freeze it. However, also a vacuum seal works best for me. It's more important in how you tenderize it.
That's really important.
More than how you're actually freezing it.
Yeah, if you take gator tail, even as good as it looks, like white meat chicken, it looks tender, it's not. It really isn't. And you say, well, that looks like it'll be okay. Nah.
Yeah, it's best to go ahead and tenderize
okay,
it.
Okay, good. Yeah, I know when I looked at it this afternoon, I said, boy, this gator looks pretty good. But then I said, I grabbed a piece of it and I kind of felt it. I said, it's pretty tough. So I used one of those mallets, meat mallet, and I kind of pounded it out. Not real hard, and it came out quite good. We're almost ready here. We're getting our fried green tomatoes. We have a call from Port Orange, or mail from Port Orange. You there?
Yes, I am, Chef.
Hey, what's your question for us?
Yes, sir.
Josh, what is your favorite dish that you like, or is there a special dish you make when the family gets together that no one knows about?
Well, if it had to be my personal favorite, it'd be venison. But alligator
venison?
Tail,
yeah, I like that
and
too.
And I fry it. I fry it very similar to how he's doing. But actually, mine, I do a marinade of mustard, just regular yellow mustard. If you use something different, it doesn't turn out quite as well. So we use regular mustard, and then I actually for my breading, I use half Bisquick and half Italian breadcrumbs. And
everybody
turns
has
great.
Their own breading. That's what I'm saying. Don't get locked into these old favorites, you know, just cornmeal, cracker meal. Come up with something. That's much better. I like Bisquick. I've used that, too.
Turns out great.
You know, I meant to mess with you here a little bit. And I need to boogie here. Here's a piece of that.
Sure. Thank you.
Okay, here we go, because we got to get that Cajun gator. All right. We got our fried green tomatoes. We're going to get this off of here, and we're going to get this pot going over here for the Cajun. And that's a pretty nice little dish right there. And what you normally do is you take a little bit of this blue cheese and put it right on the potato, and there's where your dish is right here. So that's kind of a nice dish.
Yeah, it looks nice.
And now we're going to pull this off the stove. Let me put it over here. and we're going to start cooking this Cajun gator. All right, now we're going to put a little bit of oil over here, like my little oil container.
Nice.
The green tomatoes we just made are just buttermilk. We marinated them in buttermilk, and I used a regular breading, or you can use cornmeal, salt, pepper it, and just fry it. Now, you can use different seasonings if you like. Basil, oregano, cilantro, anything that you'd like to season it up. You can use Cajun seasoning if you like. Okay, how do you like my oil bottle here? I just love this thing. Okay, we're gonna get this going. Gotta really get popping here. Every week I'm cooking, I'm saying, I gotta hurry up and get this stuff going. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. Josh, is there any special recipes that you have that you like?
For the alligator, fried is the best way. And the reason I say that is because whenever I cook it fried, it's always gone. And when I ever prepare it another way, there tend to be leftovers. So.
I have another caller on the line. Hang on, Joe. I'm going to put this seasoning in here. Hear that sizzling away there? And I put bacon in here. Now, how do you mess with that? I mean, bacon and seasoning. Put that in there. And now I'm going to put Joe from Osteen. You there?
Yes, sir.
What's your question for us?
My question is for Captain Joshua Mattson. And my question is there any difference in the alligators that are caught in the wild and maybe a farm-raised alligator?
Joe, the biggest difference is the size and how quickly they reach that size. As far as flavor, you're not going to see any difference.
Yeah, I don't see how that...
Yeah, they raise them in a controlled environment, and when that controlled environment allows them to grow quicker. So they reach maturity quicker, and it allows them to harvest them at a younger age. So, but as far as flavor, you're not going to notice any real difference.
Well, we got this Cajun really rocking over here right now. What I have in here, I put the bacon, I put all my chopped herbs, and I put the gator in there. And now I'm going to put some gator special Cajun seasoning. Y'all like it hot? Here it comes. Smell that? That's pretty good, isn't it?
Smoking.
That is smoking. This is really starting to get down to where it's going to be good. We have another caller on the line. Paul from DeLand, what's your question for us?
I've got a question for Captain Josh.
Yeah, fire away.
Captain Josh, what kind of size do you eat with gator meat?
I believe the question is what kind of sides?
Yeah.
You kind of do anything. Based starch, I like yellow rice or, he's got kind of a dark,
gotcha.
Dark grain.
That's
rice.
What I did tonight.
Yeah.
I did Cajun rice right here in front of us. This is just regular rice, but I put jalapenos in it, and I put salt, pepper, red peppers, and everything. Then I put chicken stock in it, kind of season it up, and put a little bit of butter in there. And so you're just not plain rice. And just like, say, these fried green tomatoes, that was kind of a neat twist, a little different.
Yeah, some hush puppies
right
would be good. Yeah.
Well, this is starting to really cook here over now. Y'all want to see this up close? Look at this. And that looks like something now. Oh, that's coming
off. Smells good.
It is. Boy, you can smell that bacon.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh. There we go. Now I'm going to add the cream to this and reduce it. Going to reduce this down. And that's all you do, folks. That's how you make it. And then you just keep cooking it until that cream reduces down and it's ready. So that's a pretty easy dish. Now, this same recipe can be used for shrimp, scallops, any kind of seafood. You could probably put chicken in it or pork or anything else. What's happening here right now is I got to clean up my mess that I made over here and wait for this to cook down. Josh, some of the people that I've talked to about gator kind of hesitate to eat it. They think it's got a funny taste to it and everything. But to me, it's fresh. It's not gamey or anything.
No, as long as it's prepared properly, anybody can miscook something like chicken or pork or anything else.
But it really is.
As long as it's prepared right, it's delicious.
We're going to look at that Cajun gator recipe one more time. We have 2 cups of parsley and garlic and olive oil and canola oil that I fried it in a little bit and butter. And then I put bell peppers and I put red onions and then I pounded the gator out real good, just like I told you. I use this Cajun seasoning. You could do your own seasoning if you want to with different kinds of spices. Cajun sometimes is easier for you. Salt, pepper, oregano, cumin, all kinds of stuff. And then half and half. And then once you get your dish all finished, just like we did over here, I take parsley, onions. Doesn't that look beautiful?
Yeah, nice color.
Okay, we're getting down to the end here, Josh. You know, I really appreciate you coming in and joining us today. We're almost out of time, so I want to thank my viewers and my special guest, Josh. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Local Flavors. Be sure to stop by our Facebook page for comments and to also view our local flavor recipes. Make sure to tune in next week for another episode of Local Flavors. Josh, thanks a lot. I appreciate you coming.
Thanks, Chef. Appreciate having me.
I'm going to keep cooking this down a little bit.
Smells wonderful.